back to the election now, and this campaign, more than any other, has felt like a US-style presidential battle, with the bulldozing Scott Morrison up against a bloke who never really seemed destined to be Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese. But he might be tomorrow night. Today, our political editor, Peter Van Onselen, spoke to both leaders, starting with the PM.
Prime Minister, thanks for your time. Why should Australians reward you with three more years?
Well, it's not about rewarding anybody. It's about what Australians need for the future. And they need a strong economy to have that stronger future. Unemployment has fallen to 3.9%. Over here in the West, it's 2.9%. This shows an economic plan that is working, and that's what Australians need to pay for Medicare, to pay for the important changes in aged care that we're investing in, disability support and so many other important challenges. But it's a strong economy that underpins all that. We know how to manage money, and we know with Labor, they don't, and they've already admitted that they'll have higher deficits, higher debt, which only puts up pressure on interest rates and inflation and leads to higher taxes.
What about your campaign are you most proud of?
Well, of our campaign, I'm really pleased that we've been able to set out a really clear plan, fully costed, so Australians can have confidence about the future, taking the opportunities that are there over the next 3 to 5 years that we've been working so hard for through the course of this pandemic. We have a strong economic plan. It's set out for Australians so they can have confidence, so they can choose to vote for the Liberals and Nationals, which will not only ensure a stronger economy, but this Saturday, if you vote for the Liberals and Nationals, it means you can get access to superannuation for your own home.
If you do win tomorrow's election, what is your first order of business?
Well, the first thing we need to do is act on what I've just said, and that is to ensure that Australians can get access to their superannuation so they can get into that housing market. The other major challenge is continuing to invest in the skills of Australians. That's the way you improve wages. That's the way that you support the economy.
Mr. Albanese, thanks very much for your time. I just asked the Prime Minister this. Why should Australians give you the top job?
Because Labor has a plan for a better future. We have a plan to deal with the cost of living crisis by providing cheaper childcare, cheaper energy prices, but also cheaper medicines. We have a plan to build a future based here in Australia with new industries, more secure work, lifting wages. We have a plan to deal with ending the climate wars that we need to do, and we have a plan for a national anti-corruption commission to clean up politics in Australia.
What aspect of your campaign are you most proud of?
I'm most proud that we've put forward a positive agenda about Australia's future, a plan that's about dealing with the immediate issues of the cost of living crisis, but also planning for how we get that future growth, how we train Australians for the jobs of the future by having fee-free TAFE, by having additional university places.
If you do pull off a victory tomorrow, what's your first order of business?
Well, the first order of business, of course, is one beyond our control. I will travel to the Quad Leaders meeting in Tokyo, renew my friendship with President Biden, but also develop further relations with Japan and India. I'll then return to Australia and get straight to work, getting straight to work on establishing a national reconstruction fund, on dealing with clean energy, on making sure that we put in place the structures to drive the changes that we want and we need through the economy. Labor has real plans to make a real difference to people's lives here in Australia, and I'm hopeful that Australians will vote for that better future tomorrow during Election Day.